Please rise. Grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The text for this morning's sermon is the gospel lesson of the 10 lepers. And my friends, we're not going to focus on leprosy, the disease, but what we're going to focus on this morning, and rightly so, is God telling us to have a grateful heart. You may be seated. Whenever I read this account of the healing of the 10 lepers, my mind immediately jumps to the topic of thanksgiving. Not only because this text, my friends, is the traditional gospel lesson for Thanksgiving Day, but because this text also addresses the issue of gratitude and ingratitude. This morning's gospel and thanksgiving are perfect together. Almost like turkey with all the trimmings. And today, we together with our Lord and all the company of heaven will eat and drink at the Lord's table. This is a meal far more important than turkey with all the trimmings. This morning, we will learn much about having a grateful heart. A grateful heart comes as we consider where we have been. For the 9 thankless lepers, the duty of giving thanks was lost in the excitement of them becoming new, of them being cleansed of this horrible disease. Their faith resulted in a miraculous healing from leprosy, and as soon as they saw that they were clean again, just like that, their faith was snuffed out. In their excitement to show off their newness, their faith was lost. Now we all know that human nature acts this way. We are so quickly caught up in new activities that we forget where we have been and how God has blessed us in the past. We must take time to look back and review where we have been, as a Samaritan did. You know, Paul never lost sight of the grace shown him. Paul writes, "For I am the least of the apostles, and do not even deserve to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. By the grace of God, I am what I am. And His grace to me was not without effect. No, I worked harder than all of them, yet not I, but the grace of God that was with me. Whether then it was I or they, this is what we preach, and this is what you believe." These are Paul's words to his letter to the Corinthians. And now, having a grateful heart also requires something, my friends, Something that I see in today's society is sadly lacking. Not many people today are very humble. Having a grateful heart requires humility. Isn't it interesting that the 9 who failed to give thanks to their Creator were Jews? It's quite possible that they were arrogant about their healing because of their privileged status and their privileged background. Paul relates this to the Romans. "For I wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my brothers, those of my own race, the people of Israel. Theirs is the adoption as sons. Theirs the divine glory, the covenants, the receiving of the law, the temple worship, and the promises." Yes, pride can also enter our hearts too, because of our privileged status as God's chosen ones. As baptized and confirmed Lutherans, who have faithfully and sacrificially given of ourselves to the Lord over all these years, do we presume to think that God owes us something? Do we deserve a special status before God today? The Samaritan, perhaps because of his lowly status, knew that he was not worthy of the least of all the mercies of the Lord, which had been showered down upon him. And because of his humility, he was mindful of God's grace. Having a grateful heart is a gift of God's grace. The Holy Spirit worked faith in the Samaritan's heart so that he recognized the healing, and my dear friends, most importantly, he recognized the healer. His eyes of faith were suddenly opened, and he returned having a grateful heart. It is only by the power of the Holy Spirit that we are moved to be truly grateful and to see every good thing and every perfect gift is from above. Luke says that the Samaritan fell on his face at his feet, giving thanks to him. Unfortunately, we lose that in the translation into the NIV. But that's exactly how it's written in the original language. And the Greek word, and this is interesting, that's used by Luke for thanksgiving is eucharistion. Maybe that sounds familiar to some of you. Many of you know the Lord's Supper as the Eucharist, eucharistion. As a matter of fact, Luke tells us that Jesus used the very same word when he was giving his body and blood. After taking the cup, he gave eucharistion, thanks. And he took the bread and gave eucharistion, thanks, and broke it. Dearly beloved of God, as you come forward this morning to eat his body and to drink his blood, you, the church, fall on your face before the presence of the crucified and risen Christ, your Savior. It is the Lord who gives you his body and blood in a meal where his divine cleansing is for all of us. Just like the Samaritan, we are saved through faith. This morning, my dear friends, the kingdom of God is here. For wherever the kingdom is, there is the King. And wherever the King is, there is His church. So, my dear friends, come. Come, dearly beloved of Christ. Come to His table with a grateful heart and eat the greatest meal ever prepared. This is a glorious meal that is much greater than turkey with all the trimmings. This is the meal which is a foretaste of the feast to come, a feast that we will enjoy forever and ever with our heavenly bridegroom. Come with a grateful heart and eat and drink for the forgiveness of your sins and the strengthening of your faith. And as you come, my dear friends, as you come forward with a grateful heart, also have this prayer on your heart that your desire is to be with your heavenly bridegroom. And we should all, each day with a grateful heart, raise these words to him and say, "Come quickly, Lord Jesus, come quickly." And now with a grateful heart, I leave you these words. It is with a grateful heart, and my grateful heart, that I have for all of you, for the generosity that you have shown me in these short 5-6 months. My friends, Young and I are overwhelmed by your love, by your generosity. Most of all, we are overwhelmed by the love of our Lord and His generosity, for He has given us to you, and He has given you to us. God's blessing on this Thanksgiving Day. Amen.